According to Nyabiumba Farmers Sacco General Manager Ambrose Akankwasa, defaulting has become rampant across many financial institutions due to the habit of multiple borrowing. He said people find it hard to pay back loans in a situation where they acquire them from different institutions.
Most of the clients default, and actually the defaulting has become rampant not only at Nyabiumba Farmers Sacco but almost in all financial institutions. And the main reason we have, the biggest problem, is multiple borrowing. We have clients who borrow from here, they borrow from other circles, and at the end of the day you find that the client is getting incapacitations in paying these loans. Another thing is emergency issues that maybe hit our clients.
Since Nyabiumba Sacco is dominated by mostly farmers, they encounter a challenge with climate change effects, such as heavy rains and drought that have affected crop yields, thereby lowering the capacity by members to repay back the loans in case they are all invested in crop production, as Akankwasa explains.
My clients are farmers, and as we told you, the SACO was started by farmers. And most of them are in the agriculture sector. And we have experienced climate change every day. And most of the time, natural calamities like drought or heavy rainfall, they have really affected crop yield. And this has reduced their household income, that finally gradually reduces their capacity to pay the loan that we give them.
Farming, but then after buying like crops, you find that those crops really are not the standard, they are substandard. And when they are substandard, that shows that they are not going to producing good yields. So now, what then another thing that I can see, there are even some of the farmers, they get money from SACOs as a loan, but then after they use that money in the other activities, not purposely the aim of getting it. Because we as Nyabiumba SACO, the most thing why we started this SACO is for farming. And farming goes with what digging and what not. But sometimes a person can get money from the SACO, go to enjoy pork, go to enjoy other things. Or
Nyabiumba Farmers SACO Board Chairperson William Muyambi says that some of the members intentionally default, while others acquire loans and divert them to other aspects, not the intended purpose. According to him, the SACO has been lenient to some of the defaulters, but it highly affects their operations.
The weather change, meaning the climate changes, they reduce our production. Totally, they reduce our production. When we meet a heavy rain, or when we meet a short rain season, we reduce our production.
During the meeting, city lawyer and chief executive officer for FLEB Associated Advocates, Eliabna Turinda Mporera, cautioned leaders and members of saving groups, associations, and SACOs to be financially disciplined and desist from vices of defaulting and misuse of funds whenever they borrow money. In his speech delivered by his representative, Edgar Mashemerera, Mporera asked residents to shun the habit of defaulting, saying that this will bring down the SACO's financial strength.
Basically, I've seen they have a challenge of a defaulter. That's a very bad vice, and brings down the SACO, and it brings down the members themselves. Because if you default today, be rest assured that when you come back tomorrow, no one will be here to hear you. So as you take that loan, please bear in mind that you must do whatever it takes and bring that money back.
Nyabiumba Farmers SACO started in 2004 and was registered in 2006 as a farmers initiative with 60 members. Now the SACO has 2,514 members with a number of branches all over districts in Chigezi. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.